What's up, everybody? It's the homie Truth Teller, the street reporter. And a lot of people been asking me about that whole O-Block situation. I'm not gonna lie, that shit crazy. News still got me in the flurry of that, my head, to be honest with you, because I didn't really see that happening. You know what I'm saying? But like I always said, we're not gonna jump to the conclusion already, because sometimes the FBI, the police will rush this shit from the information they get. So we're not gonna help them convict nobody that we don't know of. But like I said in several blogs, I'ma hold my free, because I ain't screaming free yet, but we don't know what the fuck happened. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, we ain't gonna convict either, man, because we gotta be smart about that. We gotta let that shit play out. And even when it play out, we still might not know what the fuck went on. You know what I'm saying? I'm just a blogger. I'm here to report the news. I don't really have a fight in this fight, you know what I'm saying? But I am a drill reporter. I'm a historian. People want to know about the culture. People want to know about good cop. It is what it is, you know what I'm saying? But a lot of people been asking me about that. I done seen the news of people getting down on the bloggers and all kind of shit. And I keep telling people, I don't think you can really blame the bloggers. I don't think that's really what's going on. Like I tell people, Duck was killed in a rich neighborhood. You know what I'm saying? The FBI involved on this. You know the resources they got. Like I keep saying, several blogs once again. Because you don't care about your town meetings and your council meetings and your neighborhood watch meetings. Don't mean these people in these nice communities don't care. These people in these rich communities care what happened to their neighborhood. And they're going to get to the bottom of it. But I've been hearing a lot of speculation. I hear a lot of people going hard on Boss Top and shit like that. Because I guess the interview that allegedly shows him just doing too much in, you know, I didn't see the interview. I watched it several times. Actually, it was done by a guy named Mikey Monroe. He do the Panda Boy things. That's who actually did that interview. I had an opportunity to speak with him this morning. He called me. I talked to him. He told me a few things about that video that he was just filming a video. He don't really know what the hoopla all about. That a lot of that shit is fan insinuated and that he didn't even ask any police questions. He said he just asked him a question about Duck. How you feel about Duck? And he wasn't trying to push people into incriminating themselves or whatever the hell. But next thing you know, he was thrown in this shit because his video recorded things that people are saying is like hidden things in the video, if you get what I'm saying. But I think that's crazy because when you watch the interview, you know, he didn't really ask anything tough, you know what I'm saying? But I talked to him. Eventually, he gonna come out and do an interview and maybe speak on what his opinion is about the whole ordeal. But I had a chance to talk to him. But like I say, if you really look into that O-Block shit, man, I want y'all to really look at this shit. Right? I didn't watch the Chicago Scenes documentaries that people claim is Chicago Scene. I ain't going there. You know what I'm saying? I watch all the documentaries, and I'm not gonna blame the documentaries because you gotta look at this shit, man. You know, you can clearly tell that it's someone that's cooperating with the FBI. Now, I'm not saying it's any one of those guys who got picked up or got arrested. It could be someone who got locked up a long time ago and found to get out a free jail card. You know what I'm saying? But you can clearly tell that it's cooperation involved. It's no documentary, no video on YouTube that named all five of them guys. Let's just be honest. It might have named a few of the guys. I see the car shit and all kinds. A lot of this shit is just speculation. You know, when you look into the indictment and you look into the real paperwork, yeah, it is things that's in there, but it clearly tells you that it is people giving out information. You know, them feds don't know all that shit. Like, you know, they don't know all that shit just off a hunch. Somebody is clearly talking with them. They know exactly who the people were. They know exactly where to pick them up at. I'm telling you, man, you got to be smart about this. You know what I'm saying? This ain't like they picked up 500 people and trying to get to the bottom of it. They picked up five specific people and whoever else they picked up to question. They knew exactly where to go. You know what I'm saying? And that shit ain't come out no documentary. That shit came out this. Now, I don't know who it is. You know what I'm saying? But I can tell you this here. It gets spooky because somebody is clearly telling the FBI what they want to know. Now, how far is it going? Is it just sticking to FBG Duck or is it reaching other people? I don't know. But, you know, we're going to be watching this case because this shit is sticky and stickier. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people getting upset. Man, y'all keep covering this news. This is one of the top drill stories that's out. So it's going to be people documenting this, unfortunately. I know it might be irritating, but it is what it is. But I just wanted to speak on that. I also had an opportunity, man, to do another interview today. Because a lot of people have been telling me that, you know, when I come to Chicago, I like to do interviews with all communities that's trending. I don't want to just stick to one community and just do interviews with all of them. I want to go to every neighborhood that trended on the internet that's involved in the drill culture. And I hear a lot about 035. I hear a lot about Lawless Gardens. I hear a lot about 035/051 Young Money. They clicked up. You know, they got a lot of rappers that's dope as hell from out there, like Hard Knocks and a lot more people. I got an opportunity to speak with a guy by the name of Young Goon, Melly Way, Snoop Life. You know, they represent that shit hard. I asked them a lot of questions. You know, I didn't ask people about Melly, but I wanted to ask somebody who considered Melly their brother, a close person to Melly, who I see in the pictures, the videos, all the time with him. And this is the person who I see, Young Goon. So I got an opportunity to talk with him about Melly, and I asked him a question that a lot of people are always asking me, man, and I don't really see nobody ask this question. You know, a little while ago, a guy by the name of L.A. Capone lost his life due to gun violence. The people that were charged were a guy by the name of Lil Mick, Rocco, and somebody else. I kind of forgot his name. But I always wanted to know about like Lil Mick and Rocco, because the internet just painted one way. A lot of people's upset about those guys having something to do with L.A. Capone murder. But I wanted to know, like, who are they? Who were they? Like, you know what I'm saying? What's something about them that we don't know? Because nobody really speak on them a lot. And he gave me some information on those guys, and I think that was dope. So that's coming in my new interview that's coming out with Young Goon. And I appreciate that too, man, because you got to understand, it was once upon a time that I was just in a room doing videos and making blogs up about these guys with the information and the sources that I had. And to get an opportunity to be in the room with these people who I was doing videos with, you know, it's kind of a little crazy, you know, but everybody understands that it's just a job. And I think that's pretty dope that people understand that. And I still got my eye out, not dope, but, you know, I think that's pretty dope, man. But like I tell people, I'm not an interviewer. You know, I'm a blogger, journalist, slash what you want to call it. But I do interview people in the drill culture, because it is questions and things you want to know about the characters in the drill culture. So I might be doing a lot more of these interviews, man, because it seems like we're getting a lot of information. So I appreciate the love. Keep the donations to yourself, because we don't need them. It's hard out here. You don't got no time to be digging in your pocket, trying to come up with some money and send it to me. Keep it. Take care of yourself, man. Do something cool with them kids. Give them the chips with the cheese and the meat. Because you know they love the chips with the cheese and the meat. And you know they love the slushies. And they don't want the slushies with the one flavor in it. You got to get the slushie. It might be $2, but they get like 2-3 different flavors. And none of them, they want. You feel me? You want to support me, though. I'm going to tell you exactly what you got to do. Pull your thumb out like this. You hit that like button. Guess what happens when you hit that like button? It make my videos grow, and a lot of people be able to see them, and they get ready to join the movement, and we can grow together. We almost at 60,000 subscribers, too, and I appreciate that. So you know we got something cool for that 60,000 subscribers, you feel me? No, I appreciate that, because I ain't do that by myself. I did that, y'all did that, and everybody who rock with me did that. No, I appreciate y'all, man. From the bottom of my heart, it's the homie Truth Teller, the street boy.